Hey everyone, in today's tutorial I will show you how to create this game logo or game title design in Inkscape, which is inspired from one of Dribble artwork. It has really nice font combination and the gradient color, so it's really great example if it's done with Inkscape. Alright, let's begin. Okay, first thing to do is add some text. Press T on your keyboard and type. Change the font to this. Press F1 and scale it up by hitting Ctrl Shift to make it proportional. Around this. Okay. Press it on here. Make the text become a pad by clicking the text first and go to pad, choose object to pad. Ungroup this by right click, choose ungroup. Now you see the letter is separate. So I'm gonna select this VIP letter. Select this. And hold Ctrl Shift to make it scale proportional. Around this. Make them close. Just hold Ctrl Shift while moving. These two. Now make it union because we want to add the path effect later. By selecting all and go to path, choose union. Let's add the path effect by clicking this text first and go to path, choose path effect. And you see this plus icon, click it and choose the band. We want to make it a little band. Then click this icon to edit on canvas. And you see this green line, just drag it up. Okay, run this, then release. Now apply the path effect by clicking this text and go to path, choose object to path. Now you see that path effect is disappeared. That means it's applied to this text. Add some text again by pressing T on your keyboard to activate the text tool. Type, change it to this font. And scale it up by holding Ctrl Shift and place it on here. But you see this font letter is intersecting. If you found this case, just click the font and go to path, choose object to path. Boom, now it's clear. Okay, I'm gonna edit this old letter because it's like cutting. So just make it the end of the line by pressing F2 and click this O letter. And I'm gonna delete this node and press delete. Okay, you can adjust this. Next, we want to add outer stroke with another method. You can see in my previous video about the game title that Lupa Adventure by duplicating this subject. Make it a stroke and move it behind. But this time, I'll show you another way to make it. Select all the text and press Ctrl D to duplicate. And go to Combine, go to Path, choose Combine. Otherwise, the stroke is not working. After choosing Combine, go to Path and choose this Outset, or the shortcut is Ctrl with close parenthesis. Just click that and I'm pressing a few times, about 13. And move it to the bottom, click this. Click this icon to, you see the tooltip is lower selection to bottom. Just click that. Let's find our text by clicking this and this. Change it to white color to make it visible. Clean these white areas with the bezier tool. I'm pressing B and draw some lines to make the white dot disappear. Okay, just swap it. Right click, just swap fill and stroke. Press F2 to select this part and our stroke. Right click, go to path, choose union. Now the fun thing, let's add some color to our stroke with gradient. Did you know you can add more than two color in gradient? So I'm gonna show you. Okay, let's make some gradient with the stroke. Click the stroke and go to your gradient tool. Just drag it down. Sometimes you found the gradient is not applied to path. It's because the path is in group. So let's make it ungroup. I'm gonna undo it by pressing Ctrl Z and click the stroke, right click, choose ungroup. Let's try the gradient again, click this and just drag it down. Press Ctrl Shift to make it straight. Okay, now you see the gradient is not applied. Never mind, if your gradient worked, just continue. And let's change the color by double click and press D to active the dribble tool. I'm going to change it to this color. Click this. You can input this color code to this fill and stroke tab menu. Okay. Can input in this. Add more color to here by go to your gradient tool again and zoom in till you can reach the line. See this plus icon, just double click. It will create the nodes. And double click this node. You want to change it the color, press D. And I want to change this color. And the last for the top, double click and click this color. Drag this gradient to adjust it. Add the shade with the outer stroke first, click this, and press Ctrl D on your keyboard. Move it to here. Can turn off this snapping. So you can move it freely and change it to this color. Move it to the bottom. Okay, I'm gonna adjust it. For the inner text, press Ctrl D to duplicate and move it to here. Change the color to this. Move it to the lower back and duplicate one more. Press Ctrl D. Okay, and place it on here. Change it to this color. Let's move it to the back. Next step, add some background with rectangle tool and click this. Turn on this enable snapping, click this. Make sure you active the snap pitch to the border so when you're in the corner of the page, it snap like this. And just drag it down to the corner of the page. And press F1 to move it to this bottom. Give it some gradient for our background. This gradient tool again and just drag it down. Press Ctrl Shift to make it straight line. Then I'm changing this color to this. For the top to this color. Draw some line with the Bezier tool. Press B on your keyboard. We want to make it clipping mask letter. And simple line like this. Press Shift to lock the corner and release. And connect it to here. Give it some gradient. Go to your gradient tool. Click this and just drag it down. For the top, I change it to this color, and for the bottom, this color. Make a clipping mask by duplicating this background, press Ctrl D, make sure it's in the front, click the pad, and right click, choose set clip. Remove the stroke, right click, choose remove stroke, and move it to the back. Oops, okay. Press F2 to adjust the gradient a little and drag it down. Lovely! So the last thing, we're gonna add some particles. Let me scale it up a little by holding Ctrl Shift. Let's make it proportional. Place it on here. And let's start with the circle. Go to the circle tool and make it gradient with this gradient tool. Drag it down. And for the top, I change to this color. For the bottom, to this. Alright, just duplicate around to this. Add some triangle. I'm draw manually with Bezier tool, press B. And draw some. And make it gradient color like this, you can go to this fill and stroke tab menu and click this linear gradient. You can see this recent color that we made. So I'm just gonna click this, remove the stroke, and adjust some gradient. Okay, take it a little and duplicate it. And let's change some shape to this color. And with Bezier tool again, pressing B and draw some. Alright, I'm gonna make a little shiny effect to here with Bezier tool. Press B on your keyboard. Click this and this. Okay, hold shift to lock the corner. Then connect to here. Make it like that. Can adjust it. Change it to white color. Make the opacity by 50 and remove the stroke. That's all. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and learned something new, how to make a game logo design in Inkscape. Don't forget to subscribe, make sure you are updated about this Inkscape tutorial. I'm Zakey from Zakey Design. Create something good today. Thanks for watching.